Hi everyone, myself Swapna Chandoda. Today I am going to explain one of the experiments in the fluid mechanics and hydraulics machines laboratory, that is the venturi meter. Okay, so generally venturi meter we are using to measure the discharge in the pipe. Okay, so in this experiment the main aim it is to determine the coefficient of discharge. Okay, so here I have drawn the diagram of the venturi meter. You can just observe here. So venturi meter consists of three parts. First part it is the inlet, otherwise we can call it as a conversion part. And next one part it is the throat part, okay. And the last part it is the outlet part, otherwise the divergent part. So you can observe here, so at the inlet, the cross-section area it is reduced, okay. So here if the cross-section area reduces, automatically the velocity it will increases and simultaneously the pressure also drops, okay. So these pressure drop and velocity, increase of the velocity, these parameters it is mainly dependent on the discharge that is flowing in the pipe loop. Okay. So we are having a one formula to calculate that discharge that is flowing in the pipe. Okay. So Q theoretical it is equal to A1 A2 into square root of 2GH divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square. Okay, so during the conduction of the experiment, you can measure the pressure drop. So that is in the inlet, throat, as well as in the outlet. Okay, so care should be taken at the inlet and at the outlet. The pressure drop it is the same because it is having a similar diameter. Only changes it is at the inlet, otherwise at the outlet and the throat section. Okay, so if you measure that pressure difference at the inlet, otherwise outlet and the throat section, so you can have the value of discharge that is flowing in the pipe. Okay, so see here this equation, Q theoretical it is equal to A1 A2 into square root of 2GH divided by A1 square minus A2 square. Okay, so in this equation A1 it is nothing but area of the inlet and A2 it is nothing but area of the throat section. If you measure the diameter, easily you can calculate the A1 and A2 values. Okay, and G it is there, so G it is nothing but acceleration due to gravity. The value it is 9.81 meter per second square. And the small letter H it is there, small letter H it is nothing but equivalent head of water that is flowing in the pipe. Okay, so for conduction of this experiment, venturi meter experiment, we need some observation. Here I have listed that observation, so just observe. First one observation, it is the area of the collecting tank. Okay, so if you measure diameter, otherwise length and breadth, you can easily have the area, that is in terms of meter square. Okay, so second one we need, that is the diameter of the main pipeline. Diameter of the main pipeline, it is nothing but inlet of the venturi meter. So I have denoted that value, it is the small letter D1, that is in terms of meter. Okay, so next it is diameter of the throat section of the venturi meter, that is D2. Okay, small letter D2 value it is there, so you can measure that diameter and that is also in terms of meter. Next value it is area of the cross section of the pipeline A1. Okay, so pipeline area it is nothing but so we have taken here main pipeline diameter. So if you use the formula, that is pi by 4 into D1 square, you can have this area. Okay, so that is in terms of meter square. And next I need the specific gravity of manometric liquid, so that is SM. Okay, so here we are using the manometric liquid as CCl4. You can use the mercury also. Okay, so in our laboratory we are using the CCl4. The specific gravity of that manometric liquid, it is 1.59 and it is a unitless quantity. Okay, so specific gravity of liquid flowing in the pipeline, always in the pipe the liquid flowing it is water, the specific gravity of that water it is 1. Okay, so along with this observation we need another one observation. So here we have taken that area of the cross section of the pipeline, that is A1. Similarly you should calculate the value of A2. So D2 you have taken. Okay, so in the throat section diameter you have already taken. So use the formula pi by 4 into D2 square, you can have the value of A2, that is also in terms of meter square. Okay, so this is regarding the observation we need before the conduction of this venturi meter experiment. Okay, so along with this observation we need a small calculation, that is the value of constant C. Okay, so C it is equal to A1 A2 square root of 2G divided by A square root of A1 square minus A2 square. Okay, so in this equation A1 A2, I told that how to take that A1 A2, and so you can substitute that value here. G it is nothing but acceleration due to gravity, 9.81 meter per second square. So similarly in the denominator also you are having A1 A2 values. So substitute all these values and if you simplify, you will get the constant value, that is nothing but C value. Okay. So we need these observation and calculation before going through that conduction of experiment. Okay. So let us, we will move to the conduction of Venturi meter experiment. Okay. So this is the setup of Venturi meter. You can observe. So I will explain the parts of the Venturi meter now. This one, it is the U-tube manometer. Just observe, U-tube manometer, it is having two limbs. This one it is the left limb and this one it is the right limb. Okay, so and also we have fixed the scale here to take the reading. So using this manometer we can note down the pressure drop. So you can observe, so one limb of this manometer, it is connected to the inlet here. Another one limb of the manometer, it is connected to the throat section. Okay, so you can observe, so from inlet to outlet we are having the uniform diameter pipe. Okay, so in this uniform diameter pipe we have fixed the Venturi meter. So this one, it is the Venturi meter. It is having the three parts as I have explained earlier. So this one, it is the inlet part, okay, otherwise convergent part, and this it is the throat section. So you can see here, this is the throat section. So you can observe here the cross section area, it is reduces, and this one it is the minimum cross section area in this pipe. And here once again gradually the area it is increases, and I will take this one, it is a divergent part, otherwise outlet. Okay, so here I need to measure the pressure drop, otherwise pressure difference, in the inlet as well as in the throat of the Venturi meter. Okay, and along with this we are having a controlling valve. Okay, so this controlling valve we are using to regulate the water. Okay, and this one, it is the collecting tank. Okay, so it is square in the shape. I told that in the observation we need the area of collecting tank. So to measure that area of the collecting tank, so you can use the scale and just measure the breadth, inner to inner breadth distance, and so you can have the formula. Area, it is nothing but it is having the square shape, so area it is equal to B into B. You will have that area, okay, for the rectangular section. And this collecting tank, it is fitted with a piezometer. You can observe here, this one it is the piezometer, and this piezometer is connected with the scale. I need to take the time taken for 20 centimeter rise of water. So using this scale you can take that reading. And here you can observe, very important thing, this is a valve. Okay, so this is for the this is related to the collecting tank. Okay, so during the conduction of the experiment this valve should be open. When you need to take the collecting tank reading, then only you can close that valve. Okay, so these are the parts of this Venturi meter. Later we move to the conduction of this experiment. Okay, okay. So let us we will see how to conduct this experiment, Venturi meter experiment. Initially you can observe in the manometer, so in the left limb and in the right limb you are having a equal distances. Okay, so just see, I am telling regarding this manometric liquid. In the left limb, how much reading it is there? So in the right limb also same reading it is there. So that means there is no difference in the pressure. This is because we have not allowed the water in the pipe. So that's why you are having left limb it is equal to right limb. Okay, when you allow the water to flow through this pipe, okay, so automatically there is a pressure difference. Then only you can note down that left limb reading and right limb reading. So I will tell now regarding the first trial. Okay, for the first trial, so I just open this valve near about 15 degree, otherwise gradually you can open this valve for the first trial, because I need to take more other trials also. So gradually I will open this valve so that the water it will flow in this pipe. So wait 3 to 4 minutes until the flow should be constant. Okay, so when this manometric shows constant reading, so that means in the left limb there is no float of this manometric liquid. similarly in the right limb also. Okay, when it is constant, you need to take the left limb reading and right limb reading, and care should be taken before the conduction of this experiment there should not be any entrapped air in the manometer. Okay, so you should remove all that entrapped air before the conduction of experiment. For the first trial, I need to take this H1 reading and H2 reading. H1 represent left limb reading, H2 represent right limb reading. So later I will move to the collecting tank reading. Here it is the collecting tank. Using the stopwatch, I will take for 20 centimeter rise the time taken. I can note down here. Okay. So this is for the first trial. Similarly, you can conduct several trials by increasing the discharge. Okay, only you need to take the manometer reading and the collecting tank reading here. Okay, so this is a procedure regarding this venturi meter. As I told, by increasing the discharge, you can take 4 to 5 trials. Okay, so let us we'll move to the conduction of this experiment. Okay, so let me start the conduction of this experiment. I opened this valve already, and I just wait for 3 to 4 minutes until the flow is constant. Okay, so just observe in the manometer. So left limb you are having a different reading and right limb you are having a different reading. So that means there is a difference in the pressure of the inlet and throat section. Okay, so using this scale I can note down that reading. Scale it is there in terms of centimeter, so you can easily note down that reading. Okay, so later I will come to this collecting tank reading. So this one is the timer. Using this timer I will take this collecting tank reading. The valve it is open, I will close this valve. So that the water it will start to store here. You can observe I have started the timer here. There is a rise in the water in the piezometer. For 20 centimeter rise I can note down this reading. Okay. Regarding the conduction of the experiment for the first trial. Similarly, for the second trial, I will increase this discharge by this control valve. Okay, and later I can note down this manometer reading, left limb and right limb reading, and simultaneously I can note down this collecting tank reading. Okay, so like that for several trials, you can have the reading of this venturi. Okay, so this is regarding the conduction of the venturi meter experiment. Okay, so let us we'll move to the tabulation for the venturi meter. Initially you are having a serial number. Okay, so how many trials you have taken, you can write it here in the serial number. And next column it is related to the manometer reading. So in the manometer reading again we are having a 3 columns. In the first column we are having a left limb reading. So we have represented that one, it is a small letter H1, and we have taken that is in terms of centimeter. Okay, similarly we have taken a right limb reading, that is H2, that is also in terms of centimeter. For different trials we have taken that 2 values. Okay, so you can note down that values in the left limb and right limb column. Next column it is related to the difference of that 2 values. Okay, so difference we have represent that value as HM, it is equal to H2 difference H1. Okay, so you will get some value that is also in terms of centimeter. And the next one column, it is related to the equivalent head of water. So formula, it is equivalent head of water, we'll denote it as small letter H. Okay, small letter H, it is equal to SM by S1 minus 1 into HM by 100. Okay, so in this formula, SM it is manometric liquid specific gravity. Okay, so I have taken a CCl4 as a manometric liquid, and in the observation I told that the specific gravity of the manometric liquid, it is 1.59. You can substitute that value, and divided by S1 it is there. S1 it is nothing but specific gravity of the water. So water it is having a specific gravity of 1. So you can have that value. And next HM it is there. HM it is there in the previous column. Okay. So you can have that values. So if you substitute and simplify, you will get the equivalent head of water in terms of meter. Okay. Next column it is related to the collecting tank reading. So in the collecting tank reading, once again we are having a time taken. So during the conduction of experiment for the different trials, we have taken a time taken. Okay, that is in terms of second, and we have denoted that value, it is a small letter T. And next column it is regarded the rise. So for all the trials we have taken a 20 centimeter rise, you can write it here, and that is represented by the capital letter R.
Next column regarding the discharge. So discharge, we know that formula QA is equal to A into R by T into 100. Okay, so capital letter A represent collecting tank area and capital letter R represent rise. So rise, it is 20 centimeter, you can substitute. So divided by T, it is there. Time taken, it is there in the previous column. Okay, so you can use that value and simplify. You will get a value of actual discharge in terms of meter cube per second. Next column, it is related to the Q theoretical value. Okay, so Q theoretical, it is nothing but C into square root of H. C value we have calculated during the observation. I told regarding that equation. Okay, so using that equation, you can obtain the value of C and substitute here. And next value, it is H, it is there. So H already calculated in the previous column. That is nothing but equivalent head of the water. Use that value and simplify. You will get the Q theoretical in terms of meter cube per second. Okay, so next column, it is related to the coefficient of discharge. In this experiment, our aim it is to determine the value of coefficient of discharge. So that is nothing but the ratio of the Q actual by Q theoretical. Okay, so Q actual already you have calculated, Q theoretical also you have calculated. That is there in the previous columns. You can use that values and calculate the value of coefficient of discharge. Okay, care should be taken, the coefficient of discharge for the venturimeter should be less than 1. Okay. And next, I want to calibrate these values. Okay, so for that calibration, I need a log values. So log QA I need and log H I need. QA column, it is there. You have already calculated. And also H value also you have calculated in the previous column. Use that one, apply the log and you will get these two columns. That is log QA and log H. If you substitute and if you calculate that log values, both these values should be negative. So that means your graph that will lies in a third quadrant. Okay. So this is regarding the tabulation for the venturi meter. Okay. So let us, we'll move to the calibration of venturi meter. So here I have drawn the nature of graph. As I told earlier, our graph, it will lies in a third quadrant. Okay. So in the x-axis, we have taken a log H and in the y-axis, we have taken a log QA. Okay. So for different trials, I have taken these graph, and if you plot the graph, you can obtain a one straight line. So this is the straight line I have obtained, and it should touch us some point in the y-axis. So I will mark that length as a log k here. From the origin, I will measure that distance. Log k should be a negative value here because our graph, it is there in the third quadrant. Okay. So later, I have taken a slope here. So this is dy distance and this one it is the dx distance. Slope n it is nothing but dy by dx. Okay. So here in this graph I need the value of the k. Okay. So I will write log k to the base 10, that is equal to, we are having some negative value here. I need a k value. So k it is nothing but anti log of minus that value. So you can have the value of k. Okay, and we know the equation, that is coefficient of discharge CD, it is nothing but k by C. In this equation, k it is a constant, so you have already obtained this from the graph. Okay, here it is the value, you can substitute that one, and C already have calculated during the observation. Use that value and you can obtain the value of CD. So this CD should be matched with your tabulation CD value. Later I will go for the chuck. So here I will write that chuck. Okay. So chuck, it is nothing but I need to write that chuck equation. Log QA to the base 10, that is equal to log K plus N log H to the base 10. Okay. So in this equation, I have taken a different trials during the conduction of experiment for uniform discharge. Okay. So in that trials, I will select a one trial value for the log QA and corresponding log H value also I will select, and I will write it here, and also log K value is there in the graph. I will use all these values, N also it is there. So write that values and simplify this equation. If you simplify that, so you should get LHS, it is nearly equals to RHS. Okay. So this is regarding the calibration of this venturi meter. So this will complete the discussion regarding the venturi meter experiment, that is a determination of the CD as well as calibration of the venturi meter. Okay.